Now let's see if we can do a run with this. Here's our game plan out at Bullet Creek. Our primary interest is this third generation BFS or binary firing system from Franklin Armory. Then we have the Echo from Fostech, so we can do a side-by-side comparison. We also bought out the second generation BFS from Franklin Armory. We pointed out some of the differences in the shop. This is certainly a more complex design than the newer third generation, with a standard military hammer, one disconnector, and an IDS to change the position of the disconnector. Then today, as far as the uppers we want to look at, we have a mid-length gas system on a 16-inch barrel. Then we have a rifle length DI 20-inch barrel. And this system was the one that ran the absolute best with the Generation 2 BFS and did very well with the Echo. Now, the problem children, this carbine length 16-inch barrel ran fairly well, but did have more problems with the second generation BFS and ran very well with the Echo. And then we have a piston upper. This is a LWRC, very nice piston upper. It has a non-adjustable gas system. And the piston uppers did not do well at all with the second generation binary fire systems. And as far as the Echo goes, remember, we have to have a bolt carrier that matches the Echo system so that it can engage the trigger block. And so with this upper, we won't be able to test the Echo without modifying the bolt carrier, which I'm unwilling to do with this particular upper receiver. But we did bring out the bolt carrier that was modified by Jack Frost. This is the modified bolt carrier. This is the Echo bolt carrier from Fostech and the standard M16 bolt carrier. So we will be able to test out this bolt carrier with our DI guns using the Echo trigger and see how it changes the feel of the trigger. Jack Frost said that his modified bolt carrier had a much lighter trigger pull when you had to reset with the pull stroke the binary function. So we'll see how this feels compared to the standard factory Echo bolt carrier. Okay, we're going to start with this Generation 3 BFS. We've outfitted this firearm the way the factory recommends. We have their light hammer spring, the blue spring, the standard trigger spring, and the factory supplied extra power recoil spring with a carbine buffer, standard M16 bolt carrier, using a DI gas system that's mid-length with a 16-inch barrel. The ammo we're using is M855. Since this is the very first time we fired this trigger, we'll just do a couple of semi-automatic fires first, make sure everything looks good. All right, now we're gonna try the binary function. And remember with this trigger, to reset the binary, it's the forward motion. You have to come off the trigger in the release pull completely for the binary to reset, as opposed to the Fostech. It's gonna be a little bit unusual going from one trigger to the other today, but we'll see how that feels and try to convey that to you. Now, let's see if we can do a run with this. Okay. And the magazine held open, that was 30 rounds. All right, before we switch uppers or triggers, let's try a different ammo with this same setup. So this is just Wolf steel cased ammo. And let's see how it runs with this. This did very well with our Generation 2 trigger. What we'll do is just leave it on binary and do a couple of double taps or controlled pairs. And then we'll go ahead and try to run the magazine and see how it does. No failures. Now, obviously there is some tuning that may be involved with this trigger, or the factory wouldn't send the extra power springs and the low power springs for the triggers and hammers. But in this setting right now, seems to be doing very well with both types of ammunition. We're going to let that upper cool, and then we're going to have the same lower setup with a Generation 3 trigger. What we've done now is gone to a carbine length DI gas system with a 16-inch barrel, and we'll try the two different kinds of ammunition and see how this Generation 3 does. At this point, I think we're just going to go with the binary, and we'll use the same technique, just a couple of double taps, and then try to run the magazine, see if we have any issues. We had some little interruptions in fire, probably from me not releasing the trigger all the way forward. Remember, when that happens, the binary doesn't reset. That's not a real issue. That's just a problem of training and getting used to the trigger so that we can get smooth, consistent runs, but we still aren't seeing these round in the chamber that has to be cleared kind of hammer follow failures. So now let's try the weaker ammunition, the Wolf steel cased ammunition, with this 16-inch carbine upper. Okay, now I mentally, before I did that run, made a note to myself to make sure to get off that trigger completely before I pulled again. And I think that was a little bit smoother. So there again, it's taken a little bit of training, but 30 rounds, no failure. Now we've gone to a rifle length, 20-inch barrel, rifle length DI gas system. We'll start with M855. Very smooth, and this was the smoothest with the Generation 2 BFS. Okay, very nice. Now, once again, we saw a couple of little interruptions there. That's my trigger discipline. I've got to get all the way off the trigger. Now let's try the weaker Wolf ammunition, see how it does. This is Wolf 223, the Lancer mag. I've got a wide variety of magazines here. They were loaded testing one of the Mag Lula range benchtop loaders, so I wanted to try a wide variety of magazines, and hopefully we won't have any magazine issues as we go along today. We'll try to discern that if it's the fault of the magazine and not the firearm itself. All right, so Wolf. Okay, let's see, we'll take the magazine out and check the chamber. Yep. Now that looks like a pretty decent, let me see if I can show you that. I don't know if that's focusing good, but that's a pretty decent primer strike. That does not look like hammer follow. Let's put that back in the magazine and see if it'll go off with the second strike. Okay, so that proves that as being an issue with that particular round. Yeah, that round's back in the chamber, was hit again, so that is not a problem with the Generation 3. That's just an ammunition problem. So we've got that resolved. Let's finish up this magazine and see how it does. We're on binary, and I'm just gonna try to finish it up. Okay, I have been using Wolf off and on for quite some time and have never had this many problems with it. We'll have to skip the suppressor part of the test. I thought that the small parts gremlin was just in my shop, but evidently he followed me out here. As I was putting the suppressor on, I dropped a little small ring that adapts to the back of the suppressor. And I just spent 30 minutes looking in an area right around the table where it dropped, and I cannot find that part. So let's go ahead now. This is kind of the ultimate stress test in my mind for this Generation 3 BFS. The piston systems did not do well at all with the Generation 2 trigger system. So once again, we're going to start with ball ammunition. We'll put it on binary. That was a release. Okay, I pulled and released. It didn't go off for that second shot. So let's just see what we have. Well, the hammer didn't follow. It's still locked back. Let's see if we have a round. Well, I'm not sure what happened then. So we don't really have a primer strike. The hammer didn't drop when I released the trigger doing a double tap. Still in binary. Try to empty the magazine. Okay, so I'm not exactly sure what happened. Okay, the Wolf ammunition, we're having all kinds of problems with that in the magazine. So let's go back to just some military ball ammo. With Malaysian, this is 55 grain ball, not the 62 grain ball. Okay, now we have a situation where the bolt didn't hold back. Let's just see. Yeah, we still got rounds. Let's see if the hammer's down. Yeah, the hammer's down, so we probably just had hammer follow. Once again, this is a typical light primer strike from hammer follow, not a dimple in the primer that should have set it off. So we do have hammer follow with this system. Now, once again, this has the extra power recoil spring, the light hammer spring, and the standard trigger spring. So this is the setup that they recommend to start with. You can tune this and see if we can prevent the hammer follow. But obviously, they haven't completely eliminated the hammer follow. I would say that this Generation 3 seems to be more reliable as far as hammer follow than the Generation 2. We have that out, and we'll run a few magazines while we're out here. This upper didn't run well at all with the Generation 2 as well. The piston uppers were a problem, and in all fairness, the piston uppers, you would have to modify the bolt carrier to even try the Echo, and I'm just not really willing to do that at this point in time. So let's go ahead now, and I think we've got a feel for this. It's an easy trigger to run. In most of the uppers that we've tried, it's been very reliable. It doesn't do well in the pistons, but I think with further tuning, you might be able to eliminate or minimize that amount of hammer follow. Now, for comparison's sake, I've gone back to the Generation 2 BFS, and this has the red recoil spring, which was the most reliable. And this is the LWRC. We have a Magpul magazine and M855 ball ammunition. We'll put it on binary and see how it does. There's a pull and a release. Okay. What we've got, check the condition of the hammer, and the hammer's down, and undoubtedly we'll have a light primer strike. Okay, typical hammer follow, very light primer strike. Okay, we'll continue with this magazine now. With the Generation 2. Okay, when I try to do a run, probably the same thing now. Confirm that. Yep, hammer down.
Yep.
Okay, light. This is just a hammer follow type of very light dent on the primer. We'll put the round back in and make sure that it's not a round problem, which I'm sure it's not. Seems to be fine with binary. Try one again. And well, that was out. So I think you can see that there's a little bit more problem with hammer follow given the generation 2 compared to the generation 3. But certainly there are several uppers that have been very reliable with the generation 3, and there were some uppers that were tuned and very reliable with the generation 2 binary fire system. It's just that the Franklin Armory trigger systems do require some attention to tuning, unless you just happen to be one of those lucky enough to put everything in initially, and with the particular upper you have, it runs like a top right off the bat. Now let's just take the uppers that we've looked at, sans the piston upper, which we're not going to change the bolt carrier on, and let's compare the echo trigger using the same combination of a magazine of ball, a magazine of wolf, with those uppers and see how it compares both in reliability, and I'll try to relate the feel of the trigger to you. Now we're going to compare the echo trigger, and we're starting back where we began with a 16-inch barrel mid-length DI gas system. Now the difference here is the springs and such are all standard. We have a standard carbine buffer weight, a standard carbine buffer spring. So the only thing that's proprietary here is we had to go back to that bolt carrier that comes with the Fostech system. We'll start with a GI magazine and M855 ball rounds, and we'll just compare how this feels. Now remember, on this system, you reset the binary by making sure you pull all the way rearward, not letting go all the way forward. So it'll be a little bit different for me. Then what I want to do is we'll run through this ball, we'll run through the wolf, and then I want to change out and use that modified bolt carrier that Jack Frost did and see if that feels different as far as the trigger pull and how it runs. We'll start with binary. We'll try to do a run. Bolt back. That was 30 rounds. Now let's try the wolf and see how that does. Still on binary with the Fostech wolf ammunition. So in that situation, it just didn't hold the bolt back, but it went through 30 rounds without any failures. Fairly smooth as far as the run goes. So reliability seems to be really good. Now that was with both wolf and military ammunition. Now what I want to do is let's use Jack Frost bolt carrier and see how that makes the trigger feel. This feels good. I would say that just subjectively, it seemed a little bit smoother to operate the trigger than the Generation 3. The Jack Frost bolt carrier modification didn't have enough material removed to allow my upper to close on my lower receiver and clear that trigger block that's part of the echo system. So when you do that modification, you'll have to hand fit your modified bolt carrier for your individual rifle and setup. So I'm real curious about that, because he did say that it significantly improved the reset portion of the trigger pull. So stay tuned. This is a borrowed bolt carrier, so I'm certainly not going to modify that. I'm going to send all of this trigger stuff back to him after we finish this video. But now I'm real curious, and so I'll do a video next week. We'll modify our own bolt carrier and see how it affects the trigger pull. So stay tuned for that. So let's continue now in our comparison. This is the Echo trigger once again. Now we've gone back to a carbine length gas system with a 16-inch barrel. We'll start with the M855 ball. And we're using Lancer magazines in this case. 30 rounds. So once again, just subjectively, I'd say a little bit easier to actuate the trigger when you're trying to do those strings. We'll go back and we'll look at the rate of fire on all of these and post those in the video. So now let's try Wolf with the carbine gas system. Okay, 30 rounds. Now, interestingly, one downside to the Echo compared to the binary fire system from Franklin Armory. Remember, if you have a trigger discipline problem and you don't adequately function the trigger to reset the binary mode, with the Echo, it takes two actions of the trigger before it picks back up. So when you mess up, so to speak, with your trigger discipline, there's a little bit larger gap in the string of fire with the Echo compared to the Franklin Armory binary fire system. So, you know, both systems have their pluses and minuses. They both certainly seem to be working well. The one thing with the Echo is that it really doesn't require the kind of tuning that the Franklin Armory system may require. But the Franklin Armory system with a standard hammer is going to fit into more applications, and you don't have to have that proprietary bolt carrier or modify your bolt carrier to work with the Echo system. So pluses, minuses. You make up your mind which of those criteria are more important for you. Now the 20-inch barrel with the rifle length DI gas system, the Echo trigger, standard carbine buffer and spring. We're back to M855 ball. We'll go to the binary mode. Okay, now I pulled and released. I have a sense that I pulled kind of light and released when I was trying to do that double tap. Now, if you don't reset with this trigger, and that was the reset problem, then I should be able to pull and it won't go off, and release and it'll go off on the release. So let's see if that was a trigger discipline problem rather than a trigger malfunction. I'm going to pull. Okay. Now I'm going to release and it should fire if it was my fault. Okay. So there again, that's training, and I'm going back and forth from these two triggers. And remember, the reset on the one trigger is forward for the Franklin Armory, and on this trigger is rearward. So I'm having to kind of mentally keep that in mind. I think once you get used to one system and practice with it, you'll get very good at trigger control. So that was just my problem. Okay, that finished those rounds off very easily. Echo trigger with Wolf ammunition now, USGI magazine on binary. Okay, same trigger issue probably. I'll pull, nothing. Now it should fire on release. Okay, there again, mentally I've got to get the full pull. Here we go. Okay, as long as I kind of mentally get in my mind which way I have to make sure that I go to reset this trigger, it's working very well. Once again, I'd like to thank Jack Frost, a fellow member of AR15.com, for letting me borrow his Generation 3 binary fire system from Franklin Armory. There are advantages and disadvantages of this system compared to the Echo system. I think that certainly the Generation 3 requires less tuning than the Generation 2 and has proven to be a little bit more reliable. The fact that this uses a standard hammer makes this system a lot more flexible as far as what host firearms this system can be used in, and I think that's a big plus. It does require tuning compared to the Echo system from Fostech. Both systems are reliable. This just requires a little bit more fiddling to get that reliability. There are still some issues with occasional hammer follow. If you have any questions or comments, please post those, and as always, I'll try to respond to those in a timely fashion. Stay tuned as I plan on going ahead and doing my own bolt carrier modification for the Echo trigger as well, and we'll see how those changes will affect the reset pull of the trigger, and see if it does in fact make that trigger easier to operate in strings of fire. I hope you found the information useful. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.